God bless you, loved ones. Welcome to the Word with Chester. Today we'll begin studying the 23rd chapter of the book of Numbers. I do apologize today. My glasses, a screw came out of them, so I have to have them repaired. They probably will be ready for us Monday, but I'm going to attempt to go through this lesson without them. I depend on the bifocal part of those for my reading, but I think we can get through this today. This won't be a long, long lesson. We're going to split this particular chapter in twos so that we won't bore you. I don't think I could get through the entire chapter, but I'm going to try to stop it at a point so we can add to it on tomorrow. The Lord loves you, my friends, and so do I. And I want you to know that I am praying for you daily, and I trust that you are praying for me as well. In fact, I asked you to pray for me on a daily basis. Let's read the Bible and see what the Word of God is saying to us. In verse 23, "And Balaam said unto Balak, build me here 7 altars, and prepare me here 7 oxen and 7 rams." Well, you need to read the entire 22nd chapter to know what this is built up to. We're building up to a climatic part. Now, if you remember in our last lesson, God had told Balaam, which was the prophet, not to go down. But Balaam went down. He consulted the Lord again. God gave him leave, and he went down. Went down to Balak, which was the king. Now we just read 23. Let me read it again. "And Balaam said unto Balak, build me here 7 altars, and prepare me here 7 oxen and 7 rams. And Balak did as Balaam had spoken. And Balak and Balaam offered on every altar a bullock and a ram." Get the picture. Now let's read on. "And Balaam said unto Balak, stand by the burnt offerings, and I will go. Perhaps the Lord will come to meet me, and whatsoever he showeth me, I will tell thee. And he went to a high place." Now, what has transpired? Now we got to get a picture here. We read in the 22nd chapter, Balak was king, and he feared the children of Israel. He feared them because they were so large in number, and they just went in and subdued other groups of people, other nations, if you please. And the news got around, and then Balak looked at the number they was, and he feared. And he sent and got a prophet. He sent and got a prophet to come back to curse the children of Israel. But we're going to get a picture here. And then I'll make a long story short. God did not want Balaam to go. Balaam was the prophet. Balak was the king. He had told Balaam not to go down there. And process of time, Balaam went because the king summoned him, promised him that he would make him a very prominent person in Moab. So Balaam went down, and here is what is transpiring here. Balaam had told him to build the altars. He built the altars and got the rams and the bullocks and brought them to the altar. In verse 2, Balak did it. Balaam had spoken, and Balak and Balaam offered on every altar a bullock and a ram. And Balaam said unto to Balak, stand by the burnt offering, and I will go. Perhaps the Lord will come and meet me, and whatsoever he showeth me, I will tell thee. And he went to an high place. Can you understand the prophet saying, I got to hear from the Lord. And when I hear from the Lord, I'm going to tell you what the Lord is saying to me, what God is saying to me. In verse 4, and God met Balaam, and he said unto him, I have prepared 7 altars, and I have offered upon every altar a bullock and a ram. This was Balaam talking to God. Now let's read in verse 5. And the Lord put a word in Balaam's mouth and said, return unto Balak, and thus shall thy speak. And he returned unto him, and lo, he He stood by his burnt offerings. He and all the princes of Moab. Well, get that picture now. Balaam had told him, Balak, to go stand by this altar while I go and talk to the Lord, while I go and communicate with the Lord. When Balaam come back, Balak was there where he had told him to stand and wait. In verse 7, and he took up his parable and said, Balak, the king of Moab hath brought me from Aram out of the mountains of the east, saying, come, curse for me Jacob, and come, defy Israel. Get that picture down. Now verse 8 reads, how shall I curse whom God has not cursed? Or how shall I defy whom the Lord has not defied? How can I defy someone the Lord has not defied? How can I curse someone that the Lord has not cursed? We find that many people, they worried about being cursed. They worried about words that come out of people's mouth, even my mouth, they worry about sometimes. But I want you to know, if you're on the Lord's side and wrapped up in the ark of safety, you don't have to worry about it. If you're not on the Lord's side, it's just time for you to repent and get on the Lord's side. When you're in his ark and in his blessings, can't nobody curse you. Get that in your mind. If you're blessed, you can't be cursed. If you're cursed, can't nobody bless you. So you got to get that in your mind. Wherever you stand, that's just where you stand. My challenge to you, if you need to get on the Lord's side, get on his side. Repent of your sins, repent of your wrongdoing, and just get on the side that the Lord has put there for you. Now verse 8 again, I'm going to reread it. How shall I curse whom God has cursed, have not cursed? Or how shall I defy whom the Lord hath not defiled? In verse 9, for from the top of the rock I see him, and from the hills I behold him. Lo, the people shall dwell alone and shall not be reckoned among the nations. Well, can you get, this is what Balaam is telling Balak, that you know, I can't curse these people. How can I curse someone that God has blessed? I'll read 9 again. And from the top of the rock he sees him, and from the hills I behold him. Lo, the people shall dwell alone and shall not be reckoned among the nations. Well, let's read on in verse 10. Who can count the dust of Jacob and the number of the fourth part of Israel? Let me die the death of the righteous, and let my last end be like his. Well, what are you saying? Balak was expecting Balaam to curse the children of Israel. And what was coming out of his mouth? But blessings. He was actually blessing them. He was actually saying good things about them. Let's read on in verse 11. And Balak said unto Balaam, what hast thou done unto me? I took thee to curse mine enemies, and behold, thou hast blessed them all together. Can you listen to yourself? I brought you all the way down here, and I brought you up here to curse them, and everything I hear out of your mouth is a blessing. Well, you got to get that in your mind. If any true prophet, they're going to say what thus saith the Lord, and they cannot be bought to tell you what you want to hear. This particular king wanted Balaam to curse the children of Israel. He wanted the words of doom to come out against Israel. But all would come out of his mouth with blessings. All would come out of his mouth with God, how God had and is going to bless them. And he even said, I want to die the death of the righteous. I want to be in that number. Well, let's read on in verse 12. And he answered and said, must I not take heed to speak that which the Lord hath put in my mouth? I can break that down for you. And he answered and said, must I not take heed to speak which the Lord hath put in my mouth? In other words, I have to tell you what the Lord has put in my mouth. I can't make up something. I can't go against what the Lord said. I am telling you what thus saith the Lord. Any prophet, that's what he's going to do. Just because you're on offer him a few dollars, he's not going to jump on your bandwagon. If he's a true prophet, and prophesy what you want to hear. He has to prophesy what thus saith the Lord. He has to prophesy what God has put in his mouth and in his spirit. When he does that, he'll be all right. When he does that, the word of the Lord will come forth. Well, you got to understand, God is in charge anyway. And who he blesses, can't nobody curse. And who he curses, can't nobody bless. Well, you can get people do that now. If one prophet says something, they'll go get another one to say what they want to hear, trying to override what he says. But if God was in his mouth, if God spoke through him, I don't care what you bring to change and turn the picture around, you can't turn it around. Why? Because God spoke through this prophet. I'll read 12 again. And he answered and said, must I not take heed to speak that which the Lord hath put in my mouth? In other words, I have to tell you what God put in my mouth. I can't tell you what you want to hear. I can only speak what God has spoke to me. Well, that's the sign of a true prophet, that he will tell you what God said and not what he thinks, not what is public opinion, not what is politically correct. He'll tell you what God says. Well, I want you to know, my friends, that's all I'm going to do is read through this Bible and tell you what thus saith the Lord. That's all I can do, and that's all I've been commissioned to do. I want you to know that I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. If you would like to contact me for any reason, you can reach me at the Word with Chester Ministries, Post Office Box 200-603, San Antonio, Texas, 78220. You can also reach me at my website, www.poemsbychester.com. Remember, I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord.